In this podcast, we would like to introduce you to the most important new features in EDIUS 8.3. EDIUS now offers Optical Flow, an interpolation method not only for frame rate conversion, but also for creating slow motion effects. When editing material with different frame rates together in one project, frame rate conversion is necessary, especially as material from action cams, smartphone cameras, or drone cameras generally record in 30 or 60p. If you add such material to a standard full HD project with 25p, frame rate conversion takes place. Until EDIUS 8.3, you had to be content with blended images. With the Optical Flow option, this is no longer the case. Using the new interpolation method, intermediate images are created. Simply click on Time Effect, Field option, and choose Optical Flow. When you save this setting as standard, Optical Flow will always be used to interpolate new intermediate images. Single pictures need to be analyzed for this process. Despite this complex calculation, EDIUS 8.3 does this mainly in real time. EDIUS's performance when doing this is excellent, especially when compared to other editing programs or software. Using Optical Flow as an interpolation method for creating slow motion effects is also recommended. When compared to other interpolation methods, the slow motion results will be exceptionally smooth. Another important new feature in EDIUS 8.3 relates to Proxy Mode. In Proxy Mode, EDIUS automatically creates proxy clips that require less storage space on your system. This way, you can edit a project even on a system that offers only moderate CPU power. In versions up to EDIUS 8.3, proxy files were only created in low resolution. Therefore, the files were heavily pixelated. In EDIUS 8.3, you now have the option to choose the resolution in which proxy files will be created. By default, they will be created in a medium resolution. These files will have a resolution of 960 by 540 pixels, which is a quarter of full HD resolution. This option is recommended for most projects if, for example, you are editing full HD material. If, however, you choose to work with SD material, you can choose the small option. A proxy file in this setting has a resolution of only 352 by 288 pixels. This setting is also recommended if you work on an editing system with a limited amount of processing power, like an old laptop, for example. If, on the other hand, you work in a UHD or 4K project, or edit uncompressed or slightly compressed full HD footage with a high data rate, then we recommend you use the large option. Large proxy files have a resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels, which is a full HD resolution. By choosing this option, you can even edit 4K projects on systems with less power and hand over big projects to a third party. Please beware that the higher the resolution of a proxy file, the more storage space is required. Another new feature in EDIUS 8.3 is related to exporting a video to disk. Until now, the EDIUS project settings had to be compatible with the DVD or Blu-ray standard in order to burn to disk. Working in projects with typical frame rates, like 25, 50, 30 and 60p, a direct export to disk was not possible. This has changed in EDIUS 8.3. In our example, we're working on a full HD 50p project. Now we would like to burn our video to Blu-ray. The Blu-ray standard doesn't allow us to burn a full HD project with 50 frames per second. Nevertheless, this option is no longer deactivated in EDIUS 8.3. To see this, we can go to File, Export, Burn to Disk. In the Format section, we can see the current project settings. If you click on the drop-down menu, you can see which formats we can use to burn the video to a Blu-ray disc. All the listed formats which are listed here are compatible with the Blu-ray standard. To burn a full HD and UHD project with 25 or 50p to Blu-ray, we recommend using the 1920 by 1080 50i option. For DVD, choose 720 by 567 50i. In order to keep your UHD or 4K project at full resolution, you need to export your video as a file. We have shown how you can do this in a previous podcast. Another improvement can be seen in the EDIUS user interface. The graphics have been improved on high-resolution monitors. In EDIUS 8.3, large parts of the user interface have been optimized for UHD screens or high-resolution laptop screens. Another new feature is that more clip information is available in the EDIUS bin window. Click on View, Tile. The timecode position of where a clip starts and ends and the duration of the clip are displayed. This information is automatically adjusted when you mark the in and out points of a clip. Also, the GV browser has been updated. In your favorite folder, desktop, video, and picture folders have now been added. Whilst playing a clip, a new button has been added that allows you to take a snapshot. Go to Settings, Import, to define the file format, quality, and storage location of these snapshots. Other new features are: in the primary color correction, F-Log for Fujifilm has been added. You can now have up to 64 audio channels when creating an EDIUS project. If you have an EDIUS Workgroup 8 version, you can now import and export MXF DNX HD files in 60, 59.94 and 50p in both 8 and 10-bit versions.